Today, I want to share a pretty tricky SAT math question with you guys. This is about a quadratic function, and let's see if we can get this right. The question is, we have f of x, which is a quadratic function in the standard form, and we know a is an integer greater than 1. And when the graph of this function contains two points, 7, 0 and -3, 0. The question is asking us, a plus b, which is this plus that, could be which of the following value? So you know the deal. Please pause the video and try this first before you see the solution. Done? Okay, firstly, we have a quadratic function in the standard form, but we have these two points. The y values here are 0. So we know that these two right here are the x-intercepts. So I can give you guys a picture real quick. Because a, the coefficient of x squared is greater than 1, which is positive, that means the graph of it will be an open up parabola, something like this. This right here will be -3, and this right here will be 7. So the key right here is, we can write the equation from the standard form into its factored form. So f of x, we can write it as the same a, and then times x minus the first x-intercept denoted by R1, which let's just call this R1, and then multiply by x minus the second x-intercept, let's call the R2, so that will be our R2. So now let's just set this up. We have a times x minus R1 is -3 times x minus R2 is 7. And now let's just multiply this out and then just kind of match the coefficients and then see what we can go from there. So a, and this right here is x plus 3 and then x minus 7. So a, okay, x times x is x squared, and then x times -7 is -7x. Then 3 times x is 3x. This and that together gives us -4x. Lastly, 3 times -7 is -21. And then distribute the a, so we get ax squared minus 4ax and then -21a. Cool. Now, remember our original equation is f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c. So from these two, you will tell us that a is just a, that's good, plus b, it's actually -4a. So we just have to do -4a right here. So this is exactly what we're looking for, which is this. Now, combining these two, a minus 4a, we get -3a. Okay, now what though? The answer choice is we don't have a -3a. So does that mean we just have -3 because maybe a is equal to 1? How about if a is equal to -4/3? Couldn't the answer be 4 as well? Well, this is the moment that we have to go back to the question and pay attention to the small given information. This right here, a has to be greater than 1. A also has to be an integer. So b right here cannot be the answer. Here, right here, if we let a equals 2, then we see the result, it will just be -3 times 2, and that will give us -6. Therefore, the answer is -6, which is a, the capital A right over there. So this right here is it. And this question is from the official released practice question. So if you guys want to do more practice questions on your own, I will have the link to the page for you guys in the description. That's it.